Saturday Night Baseball coming up from Guaranteed Rate Field in the Windy City. Tonight, game two of this three-game weekend series between the Texas Rangers and the Chicago White Sox. The Pale Hosts are looking to make history here today. Can they break the all-time winning streak record? We'll see right after this. Lucas Giolito, a California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan, any thoughts?
Boy, this guy was unbelievably good in this last one. Struck out a ton of guys in an amazing performance, and all of his pitches were working. Let's hope he brings that A game back with him in this one.
So now up steps Isaiah Kiner-Falefa, and we are set for baseball
leading
here this evening.
For Texas, the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
Now here's the first offering. Bat explodes as this has popped up, and no one will get this one.
First pitch, 6-10.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Might have thought about it here, but he lays off the breaking ball inside. It's even at one. And guys, you take a look at the White Sox entering play here tonight. They come in unbeaten and playing well here in the early going.
Matty, this is the best team in baseball right now. I mean, just a double-digit winning streak that, I mean, maybe happens to two or three teams a year you get this hot. This team is rocking in all facets right now, and they're a fun watch.
And we'll need to keep the hot chocolate flowing tonight. 42 degrees our game time temperature. With it, the throw. It's in time.
Oh, that's a tough play, but he pulled it off perfectly. Once he made the great stop, still had to make a good feed to the pitcher covering, which isn't easy on routine grounders sometimes. Hard not to appreciate that one.
Here's Brock Holt now. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Edge of the zone that time, taken and ruled a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a little blooper to center. Center fielder coming on, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
That is third. The left fielder number five, Willie Calhoun.
And here's the former Pies Dodger prospect, Willie Calhoun. Holt, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Woody Keller.
Woody Keller, this is my nightmare. He likes to call the pitch above the zone, above the belt. I know guys say those are the pitches that go deep, but I'm telling you, if you're calling that high strike, it opens up a lot of room for the pitcher.
I agree with you, Nero. That's a tough pitch to get on top of and to put it in play. So if you're a pitcher right now, try to elevate in that top part of that strike zone.
Got him.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
To the plate now, Adolis Garcia. As with two away, he'll swing and misses the first pitch. It's 0-1. Fouled off. Two out with the man at first. Pitch out.
Ball.
Nothing doing.
Play 12. 1-2 is the count.
And he fouls this one off.
Oh, the old classic two strike. Let's throw the fastball right down the middle. Not in this game. Gotta believe you gotta work the corners a little bit more. Fastball command is paramount at this level.
Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Garcia finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Rangers lead one. Time for the White Sox to go to work. No score. Gibson gets the starting assignment for the Rangers in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matt, coming on Kyle Gibson to pitch. Four pitch mix. Not an overpowering guy, more of a pitch to contact kind of guy. Fastball 89 to 93. Curveball, changeup, and slider. He's a guy you'll know if he's on early. He's going to induce a lot of ground balls. If he's getting pop-ups and fly balls, that's dangerous. He's not a power-type pitcher.
Yes, he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. And, fellas, you take a look at this Rangers team entering play here tonight. They dropped another one last time out, and, in fact, they've won just twice in their last eight tries.
Yeah, Matty, this road trip's been a little bit of a struggle for this team. First four games, they find themselves 1-3, haven't played particularly well. They'll find a way to regroup. They have to find a way to play a little bit more fundamentally sound. Start there first.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Swinging a blooper to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit.
Hey, sometimes that's how a rally gets started right there. I know it's a soft liner, but leadoff man on usually poses problems.
Will be Nick Madrigal. And this one's in the dirt. The 0-1 delivery. Runs up and gets this one down. And he will smartly swipe that ball away in foul territory, so we likely won't see the bunt again now with two strikes. And prior to the 0-2, we'll move to first. And the runner back easily. A runner at first with no outs here.
That's foul.
Line hard deep into left. And this will be hauled in shy of the track for out number one as the runner will retreat to first. Time now to check the starting lineup card for the Shy Sox in this one. Who stands out to you, Danny?
Well, Matt, the guy to watch has to be Jose Abreu. Go look at the numbers. He hit over 310 last year and was consistent most of the year. I'm looking forward to him having another solid campaign.
So here's Yoan Moncada. As with one away, he can't make contact on the first pitch. It's strike one. Career against Kyle Gibson comes in with six hits in 19 tries. Oh, right back to him on the mound. One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Second inning upcoming here on the south side with no score. Nate Lowe digging in now. And he has been, pardon the cliche, in fuego of late. Seen that average shoot up quite a bit over the past 8 ball games. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
0-1.
The windup and the 0-1. Line but speared on a hop. Throw is in time for the first out of the second.
That is a pitch.
Okay, guys, here's how the Southsiders are lining up on D today. And I'm going to focus today on Tim Anderson. And when I say his name, I think quick feet, not only defensively at the shortstop position, but also putting the defense on their heels. When he gets on base, look for him to take off. And he's got a strong arm as well from shortstop.
Chris Davis next to bat. And a ball, 1-0. He'll come into play here at 319. 9 homers and 14 driven in. Fouled away. The 1-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number 2. Here comes the 1-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike 3.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with 2 strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that. But most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
So that brings up the big bat of Joey Gallo. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike 1. Past history with Lucas Giolito. He's hitless in 3 at-bats. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Swing and a hard liner to center field. Garcia gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. Rangers set down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. Now the first pitch.
Ball. Looked like he was a little over aggressive there to throw that nasty curveball. Just needs to slow his delivery down a bit.
The 1-0. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Garcia is over a few steps as he puts it away for the first out.
Batting fifth.
Time for a look at the Rangers on D. And surprisingly today, the best arm resides out in center field. This guy's known for his range. We get it. He can go gap to gap. He's got an accurate arm. But I'll tell you what, you won't see many guys trying to take the extra base on him. He has got an absolute cannon out there.
In now, Yermin Mercedes. He sends it on the ground softly to the left. And there are 2 away now.
Batting 6. The catcher. Giovanni Grandal.
Next, here is Yasmani Grandal. He's ready for his first at bat of this early season contest. Pitch on the way. Now a swing and a deep drive to right. And bomb. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Sixth home run on the season for him as the White Sox are on the board first. It's 1-0.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that take a beautiful hack like that in the league.
Stepping in now, Leury Garcia. As he'll go after a hard sinker that time and falls behind nothing and one. And he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. Grounder down the line at third. A windup and the 0-2 pitch. Softly hit toward the hole. Fielded cleanly. Throw in time and the side is retired. But they're off to a good start as they pick up a run on this solo shot. We've played two. It's now 1-0 Chicago.
Welcome back to the south side of Chicago, where the hometown White Sox have given these fans a lot to cheer about from the mound this season. Coming into the day, they ranked first in the league in both ERA and strikeouts, a combination that has opposing lineups searching for answers. One member of the staff told me, "It's a special group of guys. I've never been on a pitching staff that's so dominant top to bottom, and I've been on some pretty good ones." Now, one of the hitters on the team told me, "I'm relieved I get to stand behind them and play defense instead of staring them down in the box. That can't be fun." Matt, back to you.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Now the pitch. As he'll come up empty there as he misses the off-speed pitch for strike one.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Right down Main Street. Caught him looking. Dad, we give you a look here at the standings entering play in the AL Central. Now to the plate, Jose Trevino, and he's looking to get it going. Off to a bit of a slow start this year. First pitch on its way. Sliced hard on the ground. Taken in by Abreu, and he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
Well, I think he got away with one right there. It was a fastball right down the middle, and he hit it hard, but he couldn't elevate it at all. Would have been a different story if he did.
Now here's the first offering. That's yanked into the stands, strike one. Didn't quite catch the zone there, ball one.
We're playing 11, 1-1.
Two out, nobody on. Ball and two strikes to the Rangers shortstop.
1-2.
Hey, make no mistake about it. This lineup's going to have to get going and get a little bit more aggressive. This guy's pounding the zone.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. They still trail 1-0. Adam Eaton. And he's hoping to get things going at the plate. It's been a bit of a struggle for him in recent games. First pitch on the way. And a swing and a miss at a pitch well off the plate. It's strike one.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Now the 1-1 pitch is laid off for ball two.
Two balls, one strike.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Wow, I can't believe the hitter took that one. The pitcher absolutely got away with a hanger.
Here now the 2-2. Is hit very well to right. This one's hammered, and it's going to go. That one is gone. Solo shot here to straightaway right field. First home run of the campaign for him as the White Sox move in front 2-0.
Well, in just a little more than two innings of work, he's given up two homers. Could be just one of those games for him. We'll see how much rope they give him. It's definitely getting shorter at the moment.
Jake Lamb standing in
the
now.
Left fielder.
As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Career against Kyle Gibson, he's 1-for-4. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. Bases are empty here, nobody out. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. Trevino finds it, but no chance to recover. Lamb is on it first after the strikeout.
Yeah, I can speak from experience, and I can tell you, on a night like this, it's tough to get a good grip on the ball. It's a little frigid out there, and he might have lost a little bit of feeling in his fingers. Never easy to make a good throw when that's the case.
And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. 1-for-1 with a single so far. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left the yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
Him up. Solak's got it, and there's one gone.
The batter, number one, second baseman, Nick Madrigal.
Now at the plate, Nick Madrigal hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Maddie. Just unlucky with the placement.
Set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch, and he'll promptly send it in the air out to center field. Gallo comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number two.
Now that the third baseman, Yoan Moncada.
Now to bat, Yoan Moncada, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And this isn't his strong side, at least not in terms when you look at the stat sheet or his consistent contact rates. I just don't think he's quite as smooth with his rhythm and swing mechanic.
Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. White Sox able to add on thanks to the solo home run. We're through three here on the south side. It's now 2-0. Good guys.
lo que pase, vamos a gozar. Traemos el sazón y somos la sal. Se puso buena. El gozo.
All set for the start of the fourth. And standing in is the veteran third baseman, Brock Holt.
Offense needs to get going right here. You want to try and tighten up this game a little bit before it starts to get into that territory where you're going to start seeing the back end of each bullpen.
First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0. Holt, a native Texan, his contract is set to expire at the end of this season, so he may end up hitting the market this winter.
You know, Matty, I know he's in the final year of his contract, but he's playing to expectations, to be honest with you. I know he wants to turn it up a little bit, though, as he approaches the end of the season and make that salary push as he heads towards free agency again.
Lifted down the line and left. Ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
At the plate now, Willie Calhoun. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. Struck out in his first at bat. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Outside.
Well, that backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's a very effective pitch. If you can hit the outside corner of that pitch, it's unhittable.
And it's fouled away.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Adolis Garcia. And there's a swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch to start him out. Nothing in one. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. He's ready. Here's the 0-1.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting a good pitch to hit are way worse.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. So a pitching clinic there as he sets them down in order, all via the punch out. More from the show Saturday Baseball following this message and a word from our local station.
Deep his last AB, certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Fouled off. I had him reaching it thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2.
See, guys, he is human. Occasionally an ugly swing right there. But he's having a monster season, so I'm going to give him a free pass.
And he fouls this one off. The 0-2 once more. Hard on the ground towards short. And that is through in the left. And an 0-2 mistake here results in a leadoff single.
Pitcher executed his pitch. Good sinker down and in. Got the hitter to beat it into the ground. Sometimes there's nothing you can do about it as a pitcher.
Into the box now, Yermin Mercedes.
Yes,
he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Mercedes hits right-handed pitching very well, makes a lot of contact, but he generally isn't known for displaying a lot of power. You'll see a lot of line drives and ground balls from him in these situations.
Yeah, I almost think he has too good of hand-eye coordination, Matty. Sometimes maybe just attacks that pitch that's not there to do major damage with, but could just drive it up the middle the other way and take his knock, and that's what he's been able to do.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he's set down for the first out.
Now batter.
And here's the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal, off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up. From the belt, the pitch. As he'll take one on the inside corner at the knees and strike one. Ready with the nothing in one pitch.
Ball.
Sinker, one ball, one strike. A 1-1 is looked at for ball number two. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. And a pitch takes off inside and it gets away. The throw is low and he can't make the pick. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, the graphic here isn't going to properly show just how far that pitch was from the strike zone. That thing wasn't even close, and I think it made the decision to move up a base pretty easy to make.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Abreu leads off second with one gone in the inning. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
Flat out locked him up with the changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two-strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
To the plate now, Leury Garcia, as he'll swing and send a chopper out to second. Scooped up, and the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. The love of the game runs deep with these folks. We're back with more on this Saturday night after this. Welcome back to the South Side as we check in with Heidi.
Matt, I talked with the Rangers manager during the inning break about the team's offensive production to this point. And he told me, overall, he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Now to the plate. Here is Nate Lowe. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How do they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now.
Wow, that's four straight K's. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number five right here. You can tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole lot of confidence in this one.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Hey, it's much easier to lay up the breaking stuff when it's coming in towards you instead of when it breaks away. A good take there.
And he will take strike three call. He's got another one. Five straight strikeouts, and that's the first out of the inning.
Man, he is looking flat out unhittable on the mound right now. That's five straight punch outs. I love it, but I think he might want to get his defense involved at some point so they don't fall asleep.
Here's Chris Davis now. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. The wind up and the 0-1. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And he'll continue this roll he's on. Make it six strikeouts in a row. Gracious, two away.
Man, this guy's on his game today, not only when he's throwing strikes, but how about the amount of strikeouts? What's even more impressive? No walks up to this point. So he's pounding that zone with strikes, and he's making these hitters swing the bat.
Here's Joey Gallo now. As the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
One of the biggest factors on how long you're going to go to start is how many first pitch strikes you throw. 80% usually means you're going to have a pretty good day, and that's on the menu so far.
Line hard to center field. Garcia gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Rangers set down in order. They're down 2-0. Bottom of the inning now, and the next at bat is speedy Adam Eaton.
A little bit of a unique home run on that last one. A changeup in off the plate that he pulled for a home run. Not a real good idea to throw that changeup on the inner half of the plate. More executed, well-executed changeups are more down and away.
Gallo has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first out.
The left fielder, number 23, Jay Lamb.
Ready now for the White Sox, Jake Lamb. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he throws the fastball by him here. 0-1.
The difference between 0-1 and 1-0 is so monumental, and this guy has been on top of his game all day, attacking the zone and getting ahead of these hitters.
And the pitch. And a slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort. Fouled away. Two runs, four hits, and no errors so far for the White Sox. Got him on the good slider there, swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Number seven.
Back to the top of the order now, and up next it'll be Tim Anderson. First pitch of the AB on its way. Swing and a miss on the slider, nothing in one.
Hey, he's rolling so far in this one as we head in to middle part of this game. How about 90% of his first pitches have been for strikes? If he continues to do that, he just might finish this one.
Waved at and missed, and he's behind 0-2.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter-friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Ready with the 0-2. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the White Sox as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. That'll bring in Nick Solak. He'll start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
Yeah, I think if I'm the hitting coach right here, Maddie, I'm telling the offense to get aggressive. Just seems like we've been going too deep in counts, and this guy has got exploding stuff on the mound. So I would tell them get overly aggressive on a heater in the middle of the plate early.